Welcome back to episode 12. Alexia Grace is still sat here answering Tyan's questions. Little does she know that a single bed at the local travel lodge awaits her, should the cult leader get lucky on his first date. Let's see how this unfolds.
I'm a woman.
Yeah.
So I can say this. I think that women's boxing is good because it's like showing that women can do a male sport. But I think that men are better to watch. But I think Sandy's an exception. I think she's a really, really good boxer.
Sometimes I think women are better to watch because
it's like a scrap in it.
Yeah, because they haven't really got that same kind of like movement, so they don't really know how to avoid punches.
Get a bit more battered.
You was getting hold up.
I had whiplash, mate.
Yeah, that was.
I was running. I was like, punch me. I don't care as long as I get to hit you.
It was your first fight, don't it? So it's
yeah, man. You go in the ring and everything leaves. I was like, had off for a jab. How many fights you had?
About 100 fights. Amateur and pro.
You're a what?
I've had 100 boxing matches, but I didn't really get to any good level.
100?
I got into alcohol and women.
And women? Are women the problem?
Yeah, when you're out every night chasing after that, you know, that dopamine of a woman and that, it can kind of cause a athlete to fuck up.
Yeah, especially when you're drinking alcohol.
Which is what I did, yeah, alcohol, chasing after that dopamine of fucking.
So. There you are with a cider.
So Tyan Booth blames his addiction to the dopamine rush for not fulfilling his potential in the ring. I've heard of alcohol and drug addiction, but never come across a dopamine addict.
I'm kind of old now, so.
How old are you?
40.
How old do you think I am?
25.
How do you know that?
Research.
How old do you think I look?
Pictures of you on my phone.
How old do you think I look?
I've just shown you.
Yeah, I've got pictures of you in my phone. I've done my research. Such a great conversation to have on a first date. This man is something else.
All these men, yeah, who message you all the time, like, you're sick of it at this point. You're just like, I mean, you're not going to say you that because they're your fan base and they're paying you, so you're not going to insult them anymore.
I don't mind. I like speaking to them.
Not when it's that much, not when it's, because I was, like I say, I was looking down the comments and these men are like, oh, you're beautiful, you're stunning, you're this, you're that. You can't reply to all of them.
And then you get the odd one, Gollum.
Yeah, Gollum. Yeah. Are you immune to all that now? You know, people dissing your looks and that? Or does it still affect you in some way?
No, it doesn't affect me. I think, no.
Because we're human, aren't we? We've got like feelings and that.
So maybe on the odd day I'll read a comment and be like, I'm so ugly. And then 3 minutes later I'll look at my bank account and get over it.
Oh, the money helps. Because what it is a lot of the time with these guys is they wanna bang you. But because they know they haven't realistically got a chance.
Oh yeah, if they had the chance they would.
I think you will find that Tyan Booth would also like to bang you as well. He has a single room awaiting you at the local travel lodge in Derby.
Well, a lot of these men hide behind
it. You find that most of the time, if someone's commenting on your stuff, they're horrible. They're in your DMs saying you're fit.
Yeah, they definitely want to smash. You have to make do with your OnlyFans. It's pathetic.
Sorry?
You have to make do with your OnlyFans, isn't it?
I don't mind them coming.
What about that guy off EastEnders who was trying it on with you? You know Robbie off EastEnders?
Dean.
That was
Robbie,
paper,
is that his EastEnders name?
Yeah, Dean Gaffney.
Mm-hmm.
He had a dog called Wellard.
EastEnders?
Yeah, he was on EastEnders. Robbie.
He literally, like, would message me all the time, and I thought I was special. And then I went on Twitter, and everyone's exposed, and I was like, oh, so I'm not special, am I, Robbie?
So did you leak that message that he sent you to the paper?
No, I put it on Twitter, and the papers just wrote about it.
So you wanted to expose Dean Gaffney, Robbie off EastEnders.
Well,
because
I didn't, so other girls exposed him first, so I just thought, oh, I'll jump on it too, because I'm not apparently special.
You may as well get a payday out of it, you know, the paper.
Exactly.
I always wondered what happened to Robbie and his dog Wellard from EastEnders. Now we know.
Weird guy.
What do you think he was going to show you?
No, he weren't on about showing me. He was on about showing me pictures of like Villa players, isn't it? Probably wanted to show me that.
Oh, you do that rating, don't you, on your OnlyFans? How much would you charge?
Depends what
me
you want
today to rate.
Well, do you want me to give you a description? Would you like a voice note or would you like a video rate?
No, if I just show you my in the toilets and give you a bit of cash, how much would that cost?
I feel like it's a bit disrespectful to do it in the toilets here, but we'll do it out on in the car park.
No, because it's too cold, so I'll be shriveled up, so it won't be accurate.
I can give you some humiliation.
Oh, come on. I can't be done with the bad women. Fuck that. We're going to toilets. I'm not a pervert. I'm just asking you.
You're just asking me how much I'd charge you if we went in the toilets, and you should be.
Yeah, because I've seen on your OnlyFans that you got.
I don't meet in person.
Well, we've met in person.
Yeah, but you can't show me how we've met in person.
No, you don't make up as you go along, man. You know what I mean?
Nah, I can't do it in person.
I'm not begging you to. I'm just asking, like, how much.
Well, if I go home, you send me a picture.
No,
on OnlyFans.
It's not real life, man. Money's isn't it? How much would you charge just in the toilet?
I'm not, 100 I'm, grand.
Oh, okay. 100 grand.
You got that?
That's a lot.
The man is dressed in a £25 outfit from Primark. How is he going to have 100 grand?
Do you want to know something weird? A guy paid me a grand 2 nights ago to pour baked beans on my head.
Yeah.
You into that?
They mess it up though, you know, for everyone else.
Why?
Because now you feel like, unless a man's giving you 2 grand, you're not going to because you've got this little idiot who's asking you to pour beans over your head. And he'll pay you, so.
Yeah, well, the men that spend are the men that, yes.
You don't respect them, do you? You ain't got respect.
Yeah, of course I respect them.
You respect them, like, because you make money from them, but I mean, like, deep down, you think this guy's a loser.
No, I don't think he's a loser. I respect them. I have respect for them.
You've got no They're social skills, like.
I have a feeling Tyan is contemplating paying Alexia to pour baked beans on her head. I hope he chooses Branston beans.
Yeah, so they got money and they're paying you for pour beans on your head, and.
And they'll go into debt.
What, to see you pour beans on your head?
Not necessarily that, but see me do anything.
They might be like socially retarded, you know, where they can't go up to women in the real world because they're so used to staring at their screens.
No, I don't think so. I think it's the modern day thing. Some of them might have, I don't know.
It's been alright, you know. Thanks for coming anyway. You're going to Thailand, yeah? What advice would you give me to avoid lady worries? Because you can have that Adam's apple, like, chiseled off, you know, that lump there.
Yeah, they look incredible.
It's fucking irritating. You know, if I bang a lady boy by accident.
Well, my advice to you is just don't bang anyone while you're there. And then you can't.
Well, that's my plan, though. Because we've been to, like, different cities. My plan is to bang someone.
Look and see if they've got a bulge.
A bulge?
Yeah.
What kind of bulge?
Like a bulge where they would be.
Yeah, because I don't know, you know when they get the surgery, when they get removed.
But then they would be a woman.
What if they were born with a penis and they've had it removed, they're a woman? How does that work?
I'm not having this conversation on YouTube.
So I can sit here and say, I'm a cat, yeah? I'm a cat, and you have to say, I'm a cat. That's bullshit, come on. YouTube's a bit sensitive, but.
From pouring baked beans on her head to spotting ladyboys in Thailand, there is some serious intellectual conversation going on here.
But I just want a hand. I want a massage.
Well, it doesn't matter if it's a man or a woman.
No,
it
definitely does matter.
Would you not
never get a
man. You can slip it in your... You're not looking.
Oh, never. No, not into that.
So when was the last time you had sex?
About a month ago in Dublin.
I'm a virgin.
Yeah, I don't do that. I don't want all that shit all over the place. I don't want all that.
I just stick with, you know? Because like a weird work until I die there.
Why would a man f*** a woman's instead of a con? Obviously, if you don't want to get her pregnant, pay child support.
No, I'm joking. I don't actually do that.
But as someone said, someone asked you a question in an interview, and they said, how do your, you know, family feel? Because now your Facebook and your Instagram are linked. So now your family and your...
What do you mean my Facebook and Instagram are linked?
Like you said, this guy did a Zoom chat with you.
Oh, yeah. So basically, my Facebook's personal. You know what I mean? Like Facebook's just like got your family on it. And it posted a TikTok and for some reason it connected to my Facebook. And for 3 days, TikToks were going on my Facebook. And then my mum rang me and she was like, why are you posting this stuff on Facebook? And I was really embarrassed. But it's not ideal. My family know. Apart from my dad, he's non-existent.
What, is he dead?
No, he's not dead.
What, he walked out, did he?
Yeah, he went for the milk. Never came back.
He went for the milk and also he abandoned you when you was a kid.
No, he didn't abandon me. My mum kicked him out.
How old is she?
11, maybe. My mum kicked him out and he made a new family. And
why did she kick him out?
He was just not a very nice person.
I'm saying he wasn't like a good dad to like no. keep you away from like the OnlyFans and the promiscuity.
I have a stepdad.
Yeah.
So it would have made no odds.
Do you know the stepdads though? They can't really like
say you
enforce
can't do this.
Those rules.
Yeah, but I've got a mum. My mum could have said that. My mum never said that though.
You know what it is with women though? Like a lot of them, they're like a bit softer, aren't they?
My mum was just like, go get your money.
That's what I'm saying. They're a bit more emotional and a bit more like, you know.
I don't really care what people think.
You know, a strict dad though, like he would have sort of kept you away from it. But you're happy to be in it.
Yeah, but then like you could have be a strict dad and then your daughter could go work at ISA from 5 a.m. for men to grope you in the aisles. I just do it all online, I'm probably safer.
Who's getting groped in ASDA?
Well, I worked in ASDA when...
I've never groped anybody.
Well, you're obviously not the type of person to go groping in ASDA, are you? But
I've never seen anyone get groped in ASDA.
I
think that's your fantasy, innit? Yeah, man.
No, actually, I was cabin crew, yeah? And somebody touched my ass while I was walking down the aisle. So that's groping, that. And nobody can touch me through the phone. I ain't got to go up and go to work.
You're talking about a very specific circumstance of a hostess getting groped. That's like a one in a million chance.
Yeah, maybe.
On a plane the other day, that's rare, isn't it?
Yeah, true, but even so, like as a woman, you're gonna get sexualized at any point in your life. Why not get paid for it?
Sexualized.
I think men just don't like the fact that women can make money from being attractive.
Why would they not like you?
I just don't think they do. I think they get jealous. There's probably so many people you know that you have no idea, but they're doing it in secret.
Just for clarity, Tyan has not groped anyone in ASDA or anywhere else for that matter. If he wants to recover this date, he really needs to change the subject.
What kind of man do you want, though? You don't want a broke fucker, do you?
I don't really care.
No, you don't. Like, imagine if just safe.
I want someone with a good personality and a good drive. I actually couldn't care less what the bank account looks like. I'm actually quite humble.
So if he was on a date with a man now, yeah, and you had to pay...
As long as he's not dirty or ordering chicken cormas.
Chicken cormas. Yeah, do you want some food or what? I know you're getting sick of all this fucking interrogation shit. I'm just interested in...
I'm on an interview. I'll get a naan bread.
Can I have a naan bread, please?
One naan, yeah?
Yeah.
Both were that engrossed into the conversation, they forgot to order food. Tyan mistakes another customer as a waiter and asks him for a naan bread.
Can I get some chicken and rice, please?
Chicken.
Gotta eat that healthy diet because you're boxing.
Yeah, it's 3 rounds. It's nothing.
Yeah, but have you got a meat weight?
No, not at all.
Chicken to be grilled or fried?
Whatever's the quickest, you know.
Could do chicken tikka for you.
Is that quick, yeah?
Have you got like, what like garlic curries have you got with chicken that's not really spicy?
Got a really nice garlic chili chicken.
Is it really spicy?
I can do it mild to medium for you.
Can I have it like not that spicy because otherwise my mouth will be blowing off?
You can do a really mild garlic chili chicken.
I'm like a proper white girl.
The cult leader looks like he's ready to test the water jug in the toilet. It is a good time to ask Alexia how she thinks the date is going.
I think he's really rude, actually, and difficult to speak to. I feel like I don't know anything about him. All I can gather is he drinks beer, and he likes women. That's all I've got from the whole conversation, to be honest.
It is Tyan's turn to review his date with Alexia sat only a few feet away.
This music's going to pick up his copyright. Copyright is a mic. It's too close here, yeah. Close, man. It's too close, but... Isn't it? Do it after. You can see he's fucking here, isn't it? It's fucking awkward.
I have no idea what the fuck that was about. We hope you enjoyed episode 12. Join us next time as Tyan and Alexia tuck into their dinner. Will Tyan Booth be able to turn this date around and coax this unlucky lady back to the travel lodge? You will have to wait and see. Don't forget, our members are 5+ episodes ahead of non-members. Join up now for only £2.99 per month. Yeah, thanks for that.